And that is that. Welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Kyle Farmer up to the plate now. That's in there.
Well, these Twins, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. They've been lining the ball all over the ballpark, and unfortunately, sometimes it's right into a glove. But still, they've hit 9 line drives so far, and that's something they should feel very good about.
That one down the line, and it goes just foul.
Speaking of those line drives, you can't get too discouraged when they don't drop in for you. It's important to remember that you pretty much did everything right, and that's just baseball sometimes.
There's a swing and a drive. Gone!
A breaking ball on the inside part of the play requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics.
Back here at the ballpark, now the number 2 hitter, Christian Arroyo.
The second baseman.
And a pitch.
Christian Arroyo.
And he gets that fastball by him up. To the final here for Chris Singleton and our entire crew. I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
Slamming when I'm gonna make sure it's broke. When I'm going, no one gets on, cause I won't let nobody press up and mess up the scene I set. I like to stand in a crowd.
Miguel Rojas at the plate. And a pitch. That misses the zone. And this one is off and running. That one fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike 2. Singy Shohei Ohtani has been as advertised. Rookie of the year in 18, MVP in 21. He has impacted the game in a major way. And then, of course, he was on the cover of MLB The Show in 2022.
Well, he's doing something that we've never seen done before, and just absolutely phenomenal that he can be that dominant on the mound and be one of the top hitters in the game. And just watching that, it's got to take your breath away a little bit if you're a manager or a teammate to see this actually happening before your eyes.
Freddie Freeman stands in here. Tried to hold back his swing there, but went around. Next offering is downstairs. That MVP I mentioned about Ohtani in 2021, he was actually a unanimous MVP and the first unanimous AL MVP since Mike Trout. Got him! Strikes out the side to begin the back in Anaheim. And our pitcher in this game, Clayton Kershaw. Chris, he is a fun one to watch do his thing out there.
Well, he comes in carrying a career ERA under 3. He's been fantastic ever since he broke into the big leagues. Can't wait to watch him pitch today.
Ripped on a line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. And next for the Angels, Taylor Ward. In the air, right field. Betts pulls it down, and there's 2 gone. 2 outs, base is empty. And now batting, Mike Trout. First pitch, just misses. Well, Singy, Mike Trout, the resume speaks for itself. A guy that's won multiple MVPs, multiple All-Star Game MVPs, a Rookie of the Year. I mean, he's going to go down as one of the best position players ever. Kershaw fires. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield. So I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Trout off of first with two away. Next offering is fouled back.
Yeah, Mike Trout, since the day he got to the big leagues, a superstar. And it's been amazing to watch, because earlier in his career, you figured he would taper off some. He wouldn't be a, you know, top three finisher in the MVP. Remember several years he was finishing behind Miguel Cabrera, and then just emerged as the guy. And incredible to see what he's done over all these years.
Kershaw really keeping a close eye on him now. Oh, and two now. Stays alive.
Well, you put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
Here's the 0-2. Ripped into right center. Base hit. Trout round second on his way to third. Trout coming home. Vargas with a relay home. Tag safe at home. And it's 1-0.
Well, to strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow-through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time.
Brandon Drury in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That's back. And it's gone! It's his sixth home run of the season, and they add to the lead. It's 3-0. Now it's Hunter Renfroe. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. And that one fouled off. The 0-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Two down, nobody on. Here's a high fly ball out to center. And the inning is over. Two-run shot for the Angels this inning. It's now 3-0. It's back here at Angel Stadium, top of the second, and here's the veteran outfielder, Mookie Betts. And that one fouled off.
They're off to a great start, 3-run lead after their first inning, but so important to be airtight defensively. Don't give away extra outs and allow that other club to get back in this ballgame.
Patrick Johnson calling the balls and strikes.
Pretty standard zone for Johnson. Sometimes he might get a little jumpy, a little excited, and expand the zone. But usually, if you at least feel like the guy on the mound is earning it, and that's important because you got to make guys earn it.
And now it's going to be Trace Thompson. There's a strike. All right, Singy, you know I'm a dork. Shohei Ohtani, go back to May 5th, 2022 at Fenway Park. He tossed a complete game through 99 pitches. Get this. 81 strikes. It was the most strikes thrown with less than 100 pitches in a game since they started tracking pitch counts.
That's just unreal.
Oh, and two now. Check swing. Tried to hold up. Now an appeal to first. And he went around. That's ruled a bottom of the second. And now Luis Rengifo.
The second baseman.
Kershaw back to work.
Rengifo.
Out towards right center field. Vargas puts it away. One down.
Yeah, that's a tough play for the infielder ranging back into the outfield. There's part of him that's saying, hey, where are you at, outfielder? Call me off. But he stayed focused and made a nice catch right there.
He swings and fouls one off. Kershaw, a former Gold Glove winner. He slider, a four-seamer, a curve, and he works in a changeup. That one hammered center field. Martinez reaching back towards the wall. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Man, I love that route. The ball was smoked. He knew he had to get back to the track right away. Turned his back on the infield. Got to the spot, turned around, and made a nice catch.
And now the lefty. And a foul ball left side. Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. Struck him out swinging. Had him out front for strike. Welcome back. Chris Taylor now. The right-hander back to work. And that's in there at the knees. Taylor, a former All-Star, hitting seventh in today's lineup, has been on a terrific run at the plate, hitting over 350 in his last 10. This to third. Zips it to first. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Trout makes the grab. Two away now. He swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Well, with the shift on, hits right into it. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. Now, Gio Urshela. And he deals. On the ground right side. Freeman over to first in time. Leadoff man retired here in the third. So up next, Taylor Ward. Center field. Martinez has a beat on it. Puts it away for the out.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Trout now at the plate as he swings through strike one.
For this guy, it's truly a battle when he steps into the box. Only one thing on his mind, seeing that pitch out of the hand and hit it hard somewhere.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Well, pretty clear to me. He's trying to go deep right there, but you got to get a pitch that you can handle.
Bounced out to short. That's the third out. Inning over. Angels back here at the ballpark. Out of the fourth. Now it's the Dodger leadoff hitter, Miguel Rojas. That's a slider for a strike. And takes low for ball one.
You know, these Dodgers just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. So many of their outs have come from weak contact on pitches they're chasing outside of the strike zone. You can't do much of anything with those locations, and that's been true again today.
The punch out there, and one away.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Vargas at the plate now. That's ball one. Next pitch is outside.
And as a pitcher, when the hitters are swinging at everything, you feel no need to challenge inside the zone. You just keep working the corners and expanding that strike zone and beyond, and they just keep eating right out of your hand.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Quite the start to this game on the mound, looking very dangerous to these hitters. Seven punchouts already, so this lineup hasn't had much success trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
Next pitch misses, 1-1.
1-1.
Freeman checks his swing. Appeal down to third, didn't go. Yeah, there's the strike. The Dodgers yet to pick up a hit here. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Nothing doing for the. Ready to go, bottom four. And now the DH, Shohei Ohtani. The pitch. Awkward swing there from the big left-handed hitter.
Off balance as well.
Singy, what do you prefer? You like watching Ohtani hit or pitch?
I think I like watching him hit. I mean, he hits monster home runs. And with guys on his team like Mike Trout and, you know, formerly Albert Pujols, to see Shohei Ohtani stand up and be a little bit taller than those other guys, it's just impressive.
Next pitch has popped up. Vargas makes the grab. That's out number two.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Renfro, the batter now, as he swings and misses for strike one. Hit hard on the ground is short. Not in time. Great effort, but it's an infield hit.
With two outs, you just want to find a way to keep the line moving for the next guy. So an infield single right there does the job. Nicely done, just putting it in play and getting down to first to keep this inning alive. You never know what might come next as a result.
Luis Rengifo gets a chance to hit here. At the belt and fires. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Oh and two now. And ball one. Renfro, the runner at first with two gone. And he grounds one back up the middle, and that is the inning. Back in Anaheim, we go to the top of the fifth, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Mookie Betts. And first offering is fouled off.
You know, these Dodgers just aren't putting together very many good at-bats in this one. We're in the back half of the game, and they're still searching for a base runner. He's been great out there on the mound, no doubt, but it's also been a disappointing performance at the plate to this point.
And now here's the Dodgers' designated hitter, Trace Thompson, into center. Trout hauls it in, and there's one away.
And as we get deeper, it's not going to get any easier. These bats are going to feel more and more desperate with every out the rest of the way.
Left field, way back there. Ward going back. Back some more. Pulls it in on the warning track. Now here is Chris Taylor. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. And a swing and a miss there.
Well, this looks like it's going to be a wasted opportunity. It's frustrating when you get the leadoff man on, but you can't get him into scoring position. They're going to need a big knock.
That ends the inning, so we take a break. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Anthony Rendon. The pitch. And it's fouled away. And here it comes. Foul ball. The wind to kick the pitch. That's off the mark, and that's ball one. Smith puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down. Here's the Angels catcher, Logan Ohapi. And the first offering is not close. This one smacked out to left center. That's a base hit. So that will bring up the top of the order with one away. Gio Urshela to the plate. Swing and a line drive curling foul down the right side. And that one is lifted in the air. Betts makes the play. Out number two. And now Taylor Ward. Yeah, we pulling up, kicking in a front. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. Kind of shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
The pitch. The other way. Makes the catch in and over. So. And the pitch. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there. Chris, when you look at the launch angle revolution, J.D. Martinez might be one of the first guys you'd come up with. Remember, he was released by the Astros in March of 2014. The Tigers signed him, sent him to AAA. He raked down there. And then once he was called up by Detroit, since then, he's been one of the top hitters in baseball. Muncy batting with one down, takes a strike. Popped up. Rendon in position. He's got it. Two down. Rojas. In his ninth season, 34-year-old vet, and he was born in Venezuela. Rojas stands in here, takes ball one low. And that one off the outside edge.
Some of the greatest players in the history of the game were born in Venezuela, including one that finished with 500-plus home runs, 3,000-plus hits, and a triple crown.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Kicks and fires. Missed inside with the curve. That one the other way. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Bottom of the sixth. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Mike Trout. Kershaw back to work. On the ground to third. Trout measures 6 feet, 2 inches, 235 pounds. Can't forget to mention he's a former MVP. Out to center. Martinez pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's one away.
Well, Boog, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ballgame at this point.
Otani in the box again, takes a strike. Action in the pen down there. Yency Almonte getting loose out there. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Another 0-2 count right here. Pitcher just in the driver's seat. He can go anywhere he wants to go right here.
In the dirt. On to first. And a couple of quick outs. Two outs, base is empty. Brandon Drury to the plate. In the air, right side. Betts makes the catch, and that ends the inning. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's the second baseman, Miguel Vargas. The pitch. Just missed. And a swing and a miss.
Man, that's just a nasty splitter. Bottom falls out of it. You don't see a lot of guys throw that these days, but I tell you what, he's got a good one.
On the ground to the left. The pitch. On the ground to third. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh. Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. This one high in the air to left center. Ward drifts towards it. Hauls it in, two away.
That's just a really nice catch on the run right there. He saved extra bases for sure. If the pitcher's his friend, he'll give him a second to catch his breath before he's ready to deal the next pitch.
Just foul of third. And the right-hander deals. Out to short, Urshela. Gets it to first, and that's the third out. Dodgers down. New pitcher for the Dodgers, Yency Almonte.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
Now it's Hunter Renfroe, one for two. And a pitch. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Hunter Renfroe hits one out, and they tack on to their lead. It's 4-0.
Welcome to the game. First pitch out of the bullpen, a tough one, and you know he's just trying to get one in there for a strike. And on the other side is a hitter. It's a great time to be aggressive and let it fly. It's not what they were looking for when they turned to him, but now he's got to find a way to reset.
And that's a base hit.
Waste no time there. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
You know, these Angels, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. We've already seen 8 line drives from them, and it's always a good sign when the ball is jumping off your bat, and that's what this offense has been doing so far today.
Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater. And next for the Angels, Logan Ohapi. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. The 0-1. Swings over the top of that one.
Sometimes being lucky is a swing and miss. If he makes contact with that pitch, probably hits into a double play.
Soft contact in the air, dives for the bag, got him! Double play! But the Angels add to the lead on this solo. We go to the 8th, and now Trace Thompson. Up the middle. Oh, look at the stop. Gathers and throws, in time, got him. And up to the plate is Will Smith. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Racing makes the catch. And there's two down. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Chris Taylor. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Swing and a miss.
Man, he is just dialed in right now. Every pitch thrown with.
He locked him up, and that'll do it. The inning. On to the bottom of the 8th. Now it's the Angels' leadoff man, Gio Urshela. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. And the righty deals. In the air, right field. Betts settles underneath it. Drops into the glove. And there's one away. And the batter now, Taylor Ward. And a foul ball. Righty delivers. Now a fly ball to right center. Martinez has a beat on it. He makes the catch, and there's two down. Two outs, base is empty. And next for the Angels, Mike Trout, 1-for-3. Swings and misses at the pitch off the plate.
Looks like he went up there guessing on the first pitch. It was going to sell out to it. Didn't make any contact, though.
Bounce to the right. Takes it himself. Gets him easily. Ends the inning. Back here at Angel Stadium. And now the center fielder, J.D. Martinez.
Boog, that hook's looking pretty sharp today. Just a solid pitching performance so far. And I really think it's because of that curveball.
Got him swinging.
Well, there's a 3-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
And there's a strike. And a swing and a miss. Just one out remaining for the Dodgers. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now 3 in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Righty to the plate. Bounced up the middle, and it's through for a hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going. Here's the second baseman, Miguel Vargas. And that one pulled foul. Rojas leads off first with two down to the inning. That's to third. Throw to first in time, and this one is over. And the Angels get a shutout on the mound.
Terrific job in this game. He scattered two hits and pretty dominant. Efficient with his pitch count, got himself all the way to the finish line and finished what he started.
Me modern trash, I am just a common fad. Wrote myself a letter for the gods. Now it's crumpled in the bottle. Took a while to start.
Inside.
Yeah. When you say you ride for me.
Ready to go here. Here's Alex Verdugo. The wind of the pitch. And that one lifted in the air center field. Taylor hauls it in, and there's one away. Here's Christian Arroyo. 2-for-7 in the series so far. Ball one, no strikes. Out to short, Correa. Throw to first is in time. Quick start here this evening. Two out, top of the first. Stepping in the long ball threat, Yu Chang. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, he threw that fastball right by him. Gives him a little bit of confidence, but in the back of your mind, you got to think, is he trying to set me up for later in this at-bat?
Next offering is in for a strike.
This guy's pounding the zone. Hitters don't have time to think in between pitches.
Lifted in the air, right field. Kepler puts the squeeze on that one. And bottom of the first. And now for the Twins, Donovan Solano. In for a strike. Strike one. And there's a hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive. Michael A. Taylor, the next Twin up to hit. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
1-0.
And that's in for a strike. Next pitch is outside. Swing and a miss. Struck him out and one gone.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got the changeup and still laid on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, there's no way.
And it gets by him. And he'll pull into second safely.
And if you're the pitcher, you can't be frustrated. You know this is going to be the toughest batter that you face tonight, and you're going to have to face him a couple of times. So you just tip your cap and hope that you can get the next guy out.
Joey Gallo, the next to hit, takes ball one. And foul ball. Going to count 1-2.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think he
ripped on a line to center. Hernandez puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tags from third. Lay it home. He's safe. And it's 1-0.
Sometimes that can be a little tough to score on. It was hit so hard that getting back to the bag to tag takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it. But a really good job of getting that run in from third.
Pitch misses there. And now it's even 1-1. In the air, left field. And the inning is over. Back in Minnesota, here's a big power threat. Rob Refsnyder. Ryan, back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Next offering is fouled back. Swing and a miss. Had him way out front of the slurve. Turner climbs in on that right side. Hitless of the first two games of the series. He's 0 for 8. Fouled off. He was late. One down, base is empty. And a big swing and a miss.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
Here comes a pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Foul ball. It stays nothing in two. And a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Pitch was away, so he definitely pulled off it there. Not what you want to do with the pitch in that location, really, but he was able to guide it into the outfield for the knock.
Puts the squeeze on it. Two down. Here's Reese McGuire. 2 for 8 in the series so far. To third. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly. Force it second, and they get the out. Stayed with it. Welcome back. Here's the power hitting catcher, Christian Vasquez. Fastball for a strike. That's strike one. Swing and a miss. On the ground, right side. The throw to first. Leadoff man retired here in the second. Now batting Max Kepler. In there, and it's 0-1. Nowadays, with advanced metrics and increased use of moving the infielders around, defense isn't necessarily about making errors. Are you able to get to the ball? Are you able to position fielders where guys hit the ball, but within the new shift rules?
In an area that goes unnoticed is the coach that's responsible for positioning, and then the research person that's providing the information. So what we're seeing in baseball, so many more people behind the scenes that are contributing to the success between the lines.
Kyle Farmer stands in now and watches strike one. Coming off a good one. 4 for 4 yesterday. Fought off foul. Back when you played, it wasn't the empirical data we have now. It was a guy with a ruler and a diamond taking a colored pencil and drawing a line where he thought someone had hit the ball, right?
That or just going off of gut or feel. What does it look like, his swing?
Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Cut. Top half of the third inning. Here's Bobby Dalbec.
The first baseman, Bobby.
Ryan, back to work. On the ground, and that chance handled. Now the throw to first on the run. Leadoff hitter gone in the third. Adalberto Mondesi up to the plate. That one back up the middle, and it gets through.
First pitch swing in, went up there with a plan to be aggressive. To me, it's just a really controlled, balanced swing. He wasn't trying to do too much with it. Just stayed disciplined, got the barrel to the ball, and put it in play. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
Double play ball to second. Good feed. That's one. It. And that's two. As we go to the last of the third, Ryan Jeffers at the plate. That one drifts inside. And a ground ball to first. Dahlbeck steps on the bag. One up, one down. Here's Donovan Solano. First offering, and it just misses. Solano measures 5 feet 8 inches, 210 pounds, and he's a former Silver Slugger recipient in the National League. Swing and a foul, pushed off to the right. And that one is lifted in the air. Ref Snyder gliding to his right, grabs it on the run, and there's two away. Now the number two hitter, Michael A. Taylor. First pitch, and he just misses. Taylor, a former Gold Glove winner, 32 years old, and he was a sixth-round draft pick. Oh, look at this. To first. In time. Got him. And that'll do it. Back at Target Field, new inning getting started. Standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Christian Arroyo. And first offering is fouled off.
You know, these Red Sox, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. They're chasing a lot of pitches outside the zone, and those chases are turning into a bunch of outs. Can they turn that around and stay within the zone? We'll see, but I think they have to.
Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. Connect on the curveball, struck him out.
I gotta think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with a high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
Chang swings through that one as he comes to the plate for the second time today. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Kicks and deals.
Call. 1-2.
Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
That's about as nasty of a splitter as you'll.
And this one ends with a final score of 6-4 for Chris Singleton and our entire crew. Here's Alex Verdugo. The wind of the pitch. Left field. And it falls. Now he'll turn for second. The throw in. The tag out. Here's the second baseman, Yu Chang. Slice the other way and foul. No score, just getting started, top of the first. And 1-2. Lopez gets the swing and the miss. Two away.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Rafael Devers stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Fastball right back to the mound. Throws to first, and that is that. Back in Minnesota. Now the starting pitcher in this one, Garrett Whitlock. And Singy, it's unique these days, but he's more of a pitch-to-contact type of guy.
Yeah, Boogie, he doesn't rely too heavily on the strikeout. He knows he needs to miss barrels, get some soft contact, let the defense do work behind him. And I think a guy like that can keep a good tempo, don't give hitters time to adjust or think. They can move through a ball game, and you look off, they're in line for a quality start. We'll see what he's got in this one.
And that one hit 97 on the gun.
I love to see guys compete, and I know he's frustrated that he wasn't able to do anything with that pitch. You see it so well, but you have to respect the upper 90s velocity. Man, it is hard to catch up to.
Next offering is in for a strike. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
He needs to throw that breaking ball with just a little more conviction to get the swing and miss.
Taps softly third base side. A swinging bunt gathers and throws to first. Inning over. And welcome back. Top of the second. So here's Boston's cleanup hitter, Rob Refsnyder. The right-hander back to work. Bounce to the left side. Over to first. And quickly one away in the second. Here's Turner now. Ground ball left side. And that's just foul. Lopez, not a big strikeout guy, but still very effective as far as starting pitchers go. One of those guys that involves the defense and really gets him involved in the action.
He moves the ball around all the quadrants of the strike zone and will add and subtract velocity. And because of that, he gets the weak contact. It's all about missing the barrel of the bat.
Here's Kike Hernandez. 3-for-11 in the series coming in. Out to short. Lewis throws to first. That's the third out. We head to the bottom of the second. Here's Byron Buxton. That's in for a strike. Right through there for a strike.
All right, now he may have not liked either of those first two pitches or agreed with the umpire's calls, but at this point, he's going to have to bear down and be ready to hit anything close to the zone.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout. Here's Christian Vasquez. Going one. And that drops in for a strike.
Quickly in an 0-2 hole, you're going to have to give something up here in terms of power if you want to put the ball in play with any authority.
Next pitch is outside.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Next one misses, and it's 2-2. Line and a base hit into right.
Well, his hot hitting continues. He's been getting great results lately. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Takes it in for the out. Throw over to first. Kyle Farmer up to the plate now. And that one sliced foul. Lined, and that's a base hit. Vasquez around second, headed for third. Vasquez headed for the plate. He'll score easily, and it's 1-0.
Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Joey Gallo in the box now. No balls and a strike.
And a foul ball.
Here's the 0-2. That one 95 to finish him off. And the Twins plate one on the double. It's now one. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. Here's Reese McGuire. Lopez back to work. And that's outside. Lopez, in his sixth season, he features a four-seam fastball, a changeup, a cutter, a sinker, and occasionally mixes in the slur. Larnick makes the catch, and there's one down. Looks like the weather could actually play a factor in this one. It's coming down pretty good.
Yeah, it is, and it's worse than this. So keep an eye on the pitcher's mound. This game a little early.
It a miss. That's the second out.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Adalberto Mondesi up to the plate. And a foul ball. Mondesi in his seventh season, hitting ninth in today's lineup, and they traded for him earlier this year. In the air, out towards right center. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Red Sox. Bottom of the inning. Here is Trevor Larnick.
There's a strike. Larnick
throws right, bats left. 26 years old. He's knocked in nine over his last 10 games. And that one is lifted in the air. And he makes the catch. One down. Here's Royce Lewis. Bounce to the right side. Over to Dalbec, and two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third. Out to short, Mondesi. That's out number three. Back at Target Field as we go to the top of the fourth. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Alex Verdugo. Gallo makes the grab, one down. Ground ball right side. Slings to first and a couple of quick outs.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And fouled off. The 0-1. And Vasquez able to pull it down. And Dever. Bottom four, here's Donovan Solano. And the pitch. And a strike.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
Chopped left side. Sends it to first. One out in the bottom of the fourth. Here's the center fielder, Byron Buxton. First pitch just misses.
One ball.
Just off the inside edge. The 2-0 is in for a strike. And that's in the dirt.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
And now it's filled up. And two away now. Christian Vasquez, the hitter. into center and a base hit.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Twins one. The wind and the pitch. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Squeezes it, and there's one down. Here's Justin Turner. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one.
These hitters are going to have to find a way to be a little more patient, see more pitches per at bat. Otherwise, that bullpen's not going to have to work over there, and it's going to be advantage pitching all game long.
Slings it across. Turner is out.
No, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
PK Hernandez.
Up the middle, Solano. Fires over to first, and that will end the inning. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Down to third baseman, Kyle Farmer. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And he takes a strike. Swing and a miss. One and two. And that one hit to first. And he handles it himself for the out. And now it's Joey Gallo. That misses the zone, and it's 1-0. On the ground to the left, and it goes just foul. Next offering is in for a strike.
1-2.
Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
You know, the danger with the slider is leaving it out over the heart of the plate and getting contact on it. If you're going to miss, you want to miss towards the corners, not in the middle. Right there, he does a great job with hard break it.
He pulls it down at second, and that. Welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. And now the catcher comes up to him. Reese McGuire. Lopez back to work. And strike one to the catcher.
I'm impressed by the number of first pitch strikes. He's not afraid of contact. Some guys, they'll nibble just because they don't want to get hit hard. That's not what we're seeing here.
Gallo takes it himself, and that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth. And a 1-0 final score here. Our entire outstanding.
People coming under me like, over. I'm like, dude, please, give me a second.
All right.
That's all I have.
We had a hunch, and I'm a critic hunch, and we ain't got no lunch, and now we eating cornbread like we ain't had a pound. Okay, like.
Coming up on the first pitch, today's starter for Colorado, Kyle Freeland. What do you have on him, Chris?
Yeah, he's definitely had a struggle so far this year, as evidenced by that inflated whip, but he's going to have to find a way to limit the base runners, put his team in a position to win a ball game. So we know he's prepared. We know this guy is a competitor. And we'll watch how he works in this one.
And first offering is fouled off. Fly ball down the line. reaches out for it, but can't make the play, and it drops foul in the corner. Liner snagged it first.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent base.
Here's Mike Trout. Enters the day third in the American League batting race. And that one fouled off. At 30 years old, Mike Trout, 1,000 runs, 300 homers, 200 stolen bases. The only other players in Major League history with those numbers at that age, A-Rod and Willie Mays. And a pitch.
That's a ball.
Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Up the middle. Fires over to Crone. Out number three. We go to the bottom of the first. Now it's the DH, Yonathan Daza. And there's a foul ball. Here's the 0-1. Next offering is outside. Line drive. And that one gets down. Fair ball. Around first, heading for two. And he's there with a leadoff double.
You know, I was watching his rounds during batting practice today. So impressed with his ability to let the ball travel, go back up the middle and the other way. Sometimes when you step in the box during the game.
And this ball gets down. It's a hit. Play at the plate. Got him. And here is CJ Crone. Slides, but he can't come up with it. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Nice line drive to the full side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Chris Bryant can't hold up, and that's a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
Blackman, the lead runner at second. Crone over at first with one away. Lifted in the air right center field. Renfro makes a nice running catch. Now it's Brendan Rodgers. Foul ball there. First and second, two down. Swung on, belted, deep left field. That one on its way, gone. Singy, this was a... Back here in Denver, second inning set to go. Here's Shohei Ohtani. Got it started a little too early. Strike one.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Blackman makes the grab, one away. Brandon Drury to the plate. And first offering is fouled off. Now one and one. Making the calls behind the plate in this one is Woody Keller.
Yeah, and Woody does a pretty good job back there, Boog. He's got a pretty fair strike zone most of the time. Maybe some inconsistency here or there, but usually he's back there doing a solid job.
Two up, two down in the top of the second. Two outs, base is empty. Hunter Renfro at the plate. Foul back our way, and that's out of play.
Fell off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
That one ripped. That's back. here. Hunter Renfrow hits one out, and they cut into the lead. It's 3-1. Luis Rengifo gets a chance to hit here, and there's a strike.
No ball, one strike.
In the air out to center, and it falls. And Anthony Rendon with a chance to make an impact with two away.
Boog, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
Anthony Rendon stands in here. Tried to hold back his swing there, but went around. That one down the line, and foul ball. That one is absolutely belted back there. And that is gone. All muscle to center field. And this game is tied. It's 3-3.
When you're working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity. He was all over that fastball.
Next to hit, Logan Ohapi. Oh, and one now. Swing and a ball popped up. Rogers brings it in for the third out. Back here at Coors Field, bottom half of inning number two, Jonathan Daza steps to the plate. There's the strike.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
On the ground, right side. And a quick out, number one. Here's Charlie Blackmon. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Blackmon swings and drives one deep to right. That one's well hit, and it's off the wall. Throws to second, and he's got a double.
Absolutely blasted that one into the gap, but just didn't have quite enough to clear the wall out there. Maybe a little more elevation under it, and it carries over, but that's a swing you'll be happy with every time.
Next offering is in for a strike. Been an interesting path for CJ Cone. Now this ball is down and could score a run. Trapp fires it to the plate, but it's offline. He will score. It's 4-3. Here's Chris Bryant now. And that's in there for strike one.
Well, baseball runs in the family for C.J. Krohn. His brother Kevin appeared in 47 games for Arizona before playing in Japan. He's also got a cousin and longtime major league catcher, Chad Moeller.
Yeah, I remember Chad. That his dad has been a longtime coach at the major and minor leagues. Rogers takes low, second trip to the plate in this one. Double steal. And a liner out into right center for a base hit. The run comes in to score from second. It's 5-3.
Four hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you...
And first offering is fouled off. Foul ball. 0-2. Got him. Two gone now. And now it's Elias Diaz. And he's already singled in this game. In there for strike one.
Well, I know they've gotten out to an early lead, but you don't want to take these opportunities for granted. With two outs, still lock in with a quality at bat. Drive in that run. You may not have another guy in scoring position the rest of this ball game.
In the air to left center. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. Back here at the ballpark, onto the third inning. So in now for the Angels, Gio Urshela. Tapped softly on the ground, Trejo. Tosses to first and one away in the top of the third. Here's the left fielder, Taylor Ward. 0-1 so far. Liner, base hit.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they...
There's a swing and a drive. And it's into the bleachers, out of here. A two-run homer, homer number 25 of the year, and they add a pair. It's 5-5.
He dropped the barrel right there. Got a fastball down at the knees where he'd prefer it. So many times now, guys are having to adjust to the elevated fastball. So I'm sure his eyes got big when he saw that one coming.
Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. One down, base is empty. On the ground. A dive. Nice stop. The throw. And it beats him. What a play.
A quick move to his left. Fully extended there in front of the shortstop to make the grab. Up with it. Then a strong, accurate throw across the diamond to complete this highlight play.
McMahon. To first. Third out. Angels do get one, however, on the Mike Trout home run. Welcome back. Set for the bottom of the third. So in now for Colorado, Ryan McMahon. That's in for a strike. McMahon in his sixth season in the eighth spot in today's lineup. And he was a second round pick back in 2013. And now the lefty. McMahon checks his swing, appeal to third, and Earl Hendricks punches him out. That's a strikeout. Next for Colorado, Alan Trejo. Out front and foul to the left side. Trejo, 26 years old, usually a second baseman, but today starting at shortstop. On the ground to third. Whips it to first. And that quickly, two away. So the lineup flips over. Yonathan Daza digging in for the Rockies. That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, some people think this is no big deal, but I think when you consider the longer throw, the fact that you've got to be able to cover up the middle to your left, it's a big adjustment for him.
Now a fly ball to right center. And that should be extra bases. Now he turns and heads for second. The throw in safely with a double, his second of the day.
He has had such a good day today. I think he's going to want to leave when it's over.
Couple of doubles today for the DH. Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make the new pitcher in the game, Justice Sheffield.
And if you dig into his walk rate, his numbers are really impressive. He's really filled up the strike zone this season.
The throw in time to get him, and that does it. Now it's Hunter Renfroe. One for one so far today with a solo homer in his first at bat. That one fouled off. The 0-1. Ripped to right, base hit.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Really stayed inside that baseball to send it to the opposite field. With the shift onto the pole side, that's an easy knock if you'll take it.
And the batter now, Luis Rengifo. High fly ball out to center field. Grichik makes the catch for the out. And there's one down. Now it's Anthony Rendon. He's already homered in this one. There's a strike.
These guys have come out ready to swing the bats early in the count and swing it often. If you want to score some runs, have an offensive explosion, that can be a route to doing it.
Next offering is foul back.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Bounce to the left side, and that's just foul. Renfroe at first, one gone. Gets a piece, and it stays 0-2. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup. Now at the plate, Logan Ohapi. Flied out his first time. Line drive, base hit. They stopped the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Urshela in the box for the third time today as he takes that one off the plate. Got to be careful with this guy. He's got power. He can untie it with one swing. Bloop behind second. Makes the play, and it's out number three. And welcome back. Ready to go. Bottom four. So in now for Colorado, C.J. Crone. And the 1-0. And that one fouled off. C.J. Crone can hit a ball a long way. In 2022, he had a 504-foot home run that was 1 foot shy of the longest homer ever tracked by StatCast. Nomar Mazara hit one 505 feet.
Yeah, that home run tied Giancarlo Stanton's 504-foot home run at Coors Field when he was with the Marlins in 2016.
And one gone in the fourth as they get the leadoff man. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Chris Bryant. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one. And that one in the air center field. And it drops in. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single. Next to hit for the Rockies, Brendan Rodgers. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Trout settles under it. Makes the grab. And there are two down. Randall Grichuk now, one for two. Check swing, but he went too far. 0-2. Bryant off of first with two away. Foul ball. It stays nothing and two. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The next pitch misses. Now 1-2. Smoked into left. Base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away. So two on with two away. And here's the catcher, Elias Diaz. Oh, now this ball gets down. Here's the throw to the plate. And he's out. Cut down, and that ends the inning. Back here in Denver, top five, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Taylor Ward. That one the other way, and a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Ground ball left side, could be two. Over to Rodgers. Next is the designated hitter, Shohei Ohtani. This guy has turned into a beast. That's out to center field. Grichuk makes the catch. And there's two away. Next to hit, Brandon Drury. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. That is the inning. Angels lead. Back here at Coors Field, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Ryan McMahon steps to the plate.
All these Rockies doing a good job of putting the ball into play, and that makes things more challenging on the defensive side. Only two strikeouts so far, and obviously they've been able to pick up plenty of hits, so it's been an impressive one. And you know, that strikeout total, only two so far, really tells you they're not just running into good luck and getting hits to fall. They're earning those knocks.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Stood absolutely no chance on that slider right there, and I don't mean to laugh, but that's a tough one. I mean, pretty much a perfect strikeout pitch. I mean, it looks like a fastball middle in, kind of has cutter action, and it just bunches you up to where you can't get your hands through and the barrel to it, and not much you can do unless you recognize the spin early and you spit on it.
Now it's Charlie Blackman. And a foul ball. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Just inside the line, and it's down for a knock. Daza rounds third, headed for the plate. He scores, and it's 6-5. Man in scoring position with two away. C.J. Krohn digging in for the Rockies. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. And a swing and a miss. Runner at second, two down. And that one ripped to left. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Key hit here by Blackman for Colorado. It's now. Welcome back. Now it's Hunter Renfroe.
Leading off of the anchor.
Freeland back to work. Slow roller to first. Krohn. Now one gone in the top of the sixth. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Luis Rengifo. In the air, center field. Grichik hauls it in, and there's two away. Here's Anthony Rendon up to the plate. On the ground, out to short. And that one finds its way through. And that extends the inning.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just one of the
new pitcher in the game for the Rockies, Denelson Lamet.
And he's been racking up strikeouts at a high rate this year, typically at least one an inning, so he'll be tough to get to.
And first offering is fouled off. Rendon off of first with two away. And the 0-2. Line drive and a base hit. So that's two straight two out hits. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. Gio Urshela steps in. Now this is in the air down the line. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. Next pitch is popped up. Krohn pulls it down, and that is the. Well, we go bottom six. Now the left fielder, Chris Bryant. Fought off foul.
Well, boo, Chris Bryant, a kid who accomplished a lot right away getting to the big leagues. Former number two overall pick, won the Rookie of the Year, was named the MVP in 2016, winning a World Series with the Cubs, over a 100-year drought. Man, you can't start your career much better than that.
Sends it across to first. Bryant out of the play.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break ball on that one. Down.
Rogers in the box with one away as he takes ball one. In the air out towards right center. And puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
As good as he's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand, you cannot hang a breaking ball right there. Lucky it stayed in the ballpark.
Grichik in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. And it's fouled away. And a base hit right there. So a two out knock keeps the inning alive. Two outs, runner at first. Elias Diaz digging in for the Rockies. Next offering is in for a strike.
No ball, two strikes.
Bounce to third. And it gets by him. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs. So first and second with two outs. Ryan McMahon digging in for the Rockies.
No ball.
One for three. And he deals. And it finds its way through for a hit. So that's three straight hits with two outs, and the bases are loaded. The throw's offline, he's saved. It's 7-5. Stepping in, Alan Trejo. Diaz at second. McMahon on at first with two down. This one popped up. Ringifo puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. But they pick up one run on the RBI. Back here at the ballpark, now the number two hitter, Taylor Ward. Away to kick the pitch. That one out to right. That gets down for a hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. Didn't try to do too much with it. Just a really controlled, simple swing. We don't see a whole lot of that these days with guys trying to launch and hit home runs. But sometimes you got to shorten up just like that.
Trout stands in now, looks at that one inside. He's already homered in this game. And it's 1-1.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And that's a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, that was an important at bat this game. So a great job there stepping up to the challenge. Textbook bat control right there. Got a pitch on the outside. Saw it deep into the zone and just barely.
Runners on the move. And he lays one down the left side. And he grabs it in foul ground. At the belt and fires. And the throw out at third. Ball to strike. Fly ball down the right field line. If it's there, it's gone. And that is gone. Shohei Ohtani with a star scraper. His 24th home run of the season. It's 7-7. And here's the first baseman, Brandon Drury. And fouled off. Still only one out here in the inning. Oh, and two now. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup. So two down now, and here is Hunter Renfro. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Fires over to Krohn. And that is the third out of the inning. But some late inning heroics as this home. Set for the last half of the seventh. And now the DH, Yonathan Daza. First offering, and it just misses. So the Angels turn to their bullpen for a new pitcher, Jaime Barilla. 25th appearance of the year for him. That one pushed foul.
Now pitching for the Angels, number 51, Jaime.
And here comes. Out to short. On the run, sends it over to first, and one away in the bottom of the seventh. Here's Chuck Nasty. That one hooked foul. The pitch. In the air, right center field. This is demolished. Way back and gone.
Well, he put a really nice swing on that one.
So they turn to the veteran pitcher in this spot, Tyler Kinley. He last pitched 2 days ago.
Number 40,
the pitch.
Kinley.
And first offering is fouled off.